Joining me now is commentator and best-selling author Douglas Murray. Douglas, the first and only debate between Kamala Harris and Donald Trump is just hours away. The Veeps team has been desperately trying to change the agreed-to debate rules. If you were advising the vice president, how would you tell her to approach this clash?
Well, I mean, she's got several problems on her hands, hasn't she? Because on the one hand, she's got to make sure that she says absolutely nothing. And that she's quite good at that, it has to be said. But she has to say absolutely nothing because we know that many of the policies that she would bring in, as Bernie Sanders admitted this week, would be pretty radical and would put off the public.
Mm-hmm.
At the same time, there might still be some journalists in America and elsewhere who will notice that she has to say something. I suspect that what she's going to do and what her advisors will have told her to do is to try to trap Trump. And they will do that by getting her to do something like the shtick she did in the last debate when she was running for Veep against Donald Trump and Mike Pence. And you remember she kept saying to Mike Pence, I'm speaking. And it was a very clear attempt to sort of say, I'm a woman, I'm also a woman of color, and therefore, if you in any way not just interrupt me, but counter me, you're kind of countering a woman of color. And, you know, steady on there. Don't you realize you're not allowed to do that? I don't think she'll use that technique, but I bet they've come up with a new one that's equally irritating and equally designed to effectively trap her opponent.
And it will be something that the media absolutely love and they'll promote it as a massive win. And yet the rest of the viewing public, not all of them, but many of them will find irritating. Now, what does Trump have to do to get in her head? Should he try to throw her off, pose questions the debate moderators are not asking? Or is he better off just saying as little as possible and letting her talk?
Well, it's a very interesting one, this. I mean, everybody sort of has ideas of how to do this. And of course, you know, very few people have actually been on the presidential stage or had a debate with these kinds of stakes. I think that there's, it's very interesting watching Trump in recent weeks as he's you know, clearly been advised, you know, stick to policy. And as he said at one of the rallies the other week, you know, the Democrats have been very, very personal against him. And how could he resist getting personal in response? That said, it's an extremely difficult conundrum for him. Getting personal, if she gets personal, and I think she's bound to, getting personal is kind of inevitable. And if he was to, as it were, rise above it, he might well annoy a lot of his base, who will say, you know, we want to see you pummel her effectively. So it's a very, very tricky situation he's in. This is why, of course, the Democrats have put her forward, is it's meant to sort of snooker Trump. Nevertheless, there are two very good lines of attack that he could do. One is to actually ask her to get specific on any policy, literally any policy, Rita. It could be anything from education to foreign policy, taxation policy, absolutely any key policy. And just get her to give any detail on it, not to say the importance of education is something we must remember, and that's why education matters, and let's all think about that for a moment. Don't let her do any of that. Actually ask her some detail. That's the first thing he could do. The second thing he could do is ask her how she squares this circle of this campaign is about fixing America, and yet I'm proud of what Joe Biden and I have accomplished in the last 4 years. Yes. There is a disconnect between those two things. Can he tease out of her what her real thinking is? We'll see.